Ages ago, a city flourished here in peace and splendor, but it was destroyed in a single day by a demon from the dark beyond. Historians claim a great calamity befell the city, but nay, 'twas a demon. The city sank below the ground, and one quarter of the old city became the demon's den. This demon put fear into the hearts of all men, and sent out minions to take the land. And its den, its palace, grew rich with the treasure stolen from all over the world. In order to increase its already formidable power, the demon created crystal stars to hold the essence of the heavens. One of these stars was placed in each country to exert the demon's influence. One of the castles built to contain these stars still stands near Petal Meadows. The demon built a dungeon near its palace and filled it with terrifying monsters. All those who fell into disfavor were thrown into this dungeon to rot. And the demon also had three dragon pets, Hooktail, Gloomtail, and Bonetail. These dragons flew across the land, spreading fear and sorrow over all. Even now, the mere mention of a dragon is enough to give some the terrors. One day, there came a hero who could vanquish the fell demon. The young toad from Petal Meadows was strong of arm, but shy of voice. All those around the boy teased him endlessly about the way he spoke. But when the demon cast his fearful gaze across the lands and reached out, the young toad used strength and honor to defend his people, and he became a hero to all, despite his odd voice. There was a wise Goomba from Boggly Woods, gifted in knowledge of the world. When beasts rose to take the woods, this knowledge helped the people fight them, and the Goomba, who knew the way that every monster would attack, she began to think of a way to banish all monsters from the land. A Koopa Troopa, who traveled the world alone, learned of the darkness covering the land. He went alone wherever evil dwelt and banished it with shell and sheer bravado. The monsters grew to fear this scar-riddled Koopa, who thwarted them at every turn. But the brave Koopa was finally taken in a trap set for him by the monsters. But then, a Boo who fought with the monsters came and used her magic to free him. The brave Koopa's spirit melted the heart of the cold Boo lass. The Boo used her powerful magic to learn more about the evil they faced. "We cannot destroy this darkness alone," she decided, her face a grim mask. "We need the Toad Hero of Petal Meadows and the wise Goomba of Boggly Woods." The Boo's magic drew the four heroes together to send the demon from the world. And so, the four heroes finally set out to the Palace of Shadow. The power of the world-devouring demon was more powerful than any could imagine, but the wise Goomba soon realized that this was the power of the crystal stars. She thought of a way to take the stars and use them against the demon. She told the other heroes her plan and set it in motion, banishing their fears. The Boo's magic and the Toad's strength created a gap in the demon's defenses. At that moment, the brave Koopa seized the stars and succeeded in badly damaging the demon. But even the grave Koopa A stroke was not enough to end the demon's reign. The wise Goomba thought of another use for the crystal stars in that dire hour. She suggested sealing the demon forever with the crystal stars. All agreed. The heroes matched their strengths with the power of the crystal stars, and they successfully sealed the demon's soul within the deepest parts of the palace. Together, they made it out so that only all seven stars could break the seal. The four heroes thought they had sealed away the demon and all of its power, but the demon used a tiny opening before the seal was complete to curse them all. While holding the crystal stars, they felt nothing, but when they let them go, a black box would appear to seal their souls within. The four heroes traveled the world, scattering the stars so the seal would remain, but the last four stars each carried the curse, which claimed each hero. The hiding places of many of the crystal stars have now faded into legend, but some say that the wise Goomba hid one in the great tree. At that time, many monsters wandered in the nearby Boggly Woods. The tiny punies were always tormented by their fierce appetites, it was said. Pitying them, the Goomba hollowed out the great tree for the punies to live in. The punies were so grateful, they swore to protect the crystal star there. Once the Boo heroine hid her star in a steeple, she was trapped in the nearby town. Some say the crystal star lies in that steeple still. The Koopa hero went to a southern isle to hide his star where none would find it. But the Koopa was so tired from his journey that the pirate Cortez stole it easily. In that very instant, the Koopa was trapped in an inescapable chest. But Cortez did not realize the power of the star and lost it among his treasures. The strong toad held his star and continued his arduous journey. But eventually, the miles took their toll upon him, and he collapsed. A traveling healer happened by and saved his life, but the toad knew his fate was to be trapped in the box when the star was gone. So he asked the healer to hide the star in a secret place known to no one. After the demon was sealed within the Palace of Shadow, many refused to come near that place of terror. But as the years passed, entire generations forgot, and the penniless and the immoral began to congregate in this once barren place. This place soon became a populous harbor, the town of Rogueport. And some even began to say that the underground city held a legendary treasure. But they were unaware. The demon slept beneath them still. The heroes knew the seal might not last forever, and they sought to make the crystal stars available to one who might need them. So, before going to their individual dooms, they made a map to all the stars. And to prevent an evil force from misusing this map, they placed it in a box that could only be opened by the pure of heart.